If you enjoy the content on this channel, please like and subscribe. Maestro is a 2023 American biographical romantic drama film that centers on the relationship between American composer Leonard Bernstein and his wife Felicia Montealegre. It was directed by Bradley Cooper from a screenplay he wrote with Josh Singer. It was produced by Cooper, Martin Scorsese, Steven Spielberg, Kristie Macosko Krieger, Fred Berner, and Amy Durning. The film stars Carey Mulligan as Montealegre alongside Cooper as Bernstein, Matt Bomer, Maya Hawke, and Sarah Silverman also appear in supporting roles. Maestro premiered at the 80th Venice International Film Festival on September 2nd, 2023. It was nominated for the Golden Lion. The film received a limited theatrical release on November 22nd, 2023, before being released on Netflix on December 20th. It received positive reviews from critics and was named one of the top 10 films of 2023 by the National Board of Review and the American Film Institute. The film received 7 Academy Award nominations, including Best Picture, Best Actor for Cooper, Best Actress for Mulligan, as well as nominations for 7 BAFTA Awards, 4 Golden Globe Awards, and 2 Screen Actors Guild Awards. In 2008, producers Fred Berner and Amy Durning approached the Bernstein family to negotiate Leonard Bernstein's life and music rights. Once retaining the rights, Berner and Durning approached Josh Singer to develop and write a screenplay and attached Martin Scorsese as the director. The project went into development at Paramount Pictures. In 2017, Scorsese stepped down as director to work on The Irishman. Briefly, Steven Spielberg considered directing the film and approached Bradley Cooper to star. When Spielberg decided not to direct the film, Cooper said he wanted to throw his hat into the ring as a possible director. In May 2018, Cooper was firmly attached as both director and to star as Bernstein after Spielberg saw a pre-release screening of A Star Is Born, a film that Cooper directed. Berning, Durning and Scorsese continued on as producers alongside Spielberg and Kristie Macosko Krieger of Amblin Entertainment. In January 2020, the project was moved to Netflix. In September 2020, Carey Mulligan was cast. Whilst in October of that year, Jeremy Strong joined the cast as John Gruen, but later dropped out due to scheduling conflicts. Josh Hamilton was cast in his place. Maestro features Bernstein compositions that were handpicked by Cooper. These pieces were performed by the London Symphony Orchestra, with a few choral performances by the London Symphony or Chorus, conducted by Yannick Nesdek-Sugen, who also served as Cooper's conducting coach. The soundtrack was preceded with an excerpt from the finale of Mahler's Symphony No. 2, Resurrection, as a single on October 20th. The full soundtrack was released by Deutsche Grammophon digitally on November 10th and released physically on December 1st. The music played by Bernstein at the piano during the prologue comes from his 1983 opera, A Quiet Place, which depicts a dysfunctional family, including an estranged gay son whose mother has just died. Cooper's use of a large prosthetic nose to portray Bernstein, who was Jewish, was criticized by some as an example of Jew face, following the release of photographs from the set of the film in May 2023 and the subsequent release of the trailer in August. The chief television critic of The Hollywood Reporter, Daniel Feinberg, criticized in a Twitter post casting of Cooper along with British Gentile Mulligan as Costa Rican Chilean converted Jew, saying a lot of ethnic cosplay for one movie. English Jewish actress Tracy Ann Opperman wrote that if Cooper can't play the role through the power of acting alone, then don't cast him, get a Jewish actor. She felt that Cooper had portrayed Joseph Merrick, a 19th century British man who had severe facial deformities without prosthetics, then he should be able to manage to play a Jewish man without one too, she would say. Bernstein's children defended Cooper's use of prosthetic makeup to portray him, stating that they worked with Cooper throughout the filmmaking process and that their dad would have been fine with it. The Anti-Defamation League noted historical media portrayal of Jews as evil characters with large hooked noses, but said that the film, which is biopic, is not that. In September 2023, Kayetsu Hiru, who created the prosthetic, said that he was surprised by the criticism and that he was sorry if he hurt some people's feelings. He added that our only intention was to portray Bernstein as authentically as possible. The New Yorker published an essay defending the special effects makeup used by Hiro in the film and numbered him as amongst the top 3 or 4 special effects makeup artists of the past 50 years, stating the film's background intentions, as in the beginning Hiro worked on the prosthetic treatment that was, in Cooper's words, totally Lenny. But Cooper himself felt it didn't look real. We wanted to find a medium between Lenny and me, he explained, so we created this hybrid. The most difficult years for Hiro to recreate were Bernstein's final ones. Even late in life, Bernstein was flirtatious. Cooper felt that the 70-something Bernstein still needed to look a bit sexy. Some interesting trivia notes. Bradley Cooper said his interest in Bernstein started with Tom and Jerry and the Bugs Bunny as a kid, watching them conduct and asking Santa Claus for a baton when I was about 8 or so, he would say. I just became obsessed with conducting. It was magical. And that the sound comes out, you know, and that's where it begins. It was just an incredible feeling of being a maestro, really. Of the scene in which Leonard Bernstein conducts the London Symphony Orchestra at the Ely Cathedral in 1976, Cooper said, "That scene, I was so worried about it because we did it live. I was recorded live. I had to conduct them. I spent 6 years learning how to conduct 6 minutes and 21 seconds of music. I was able to get the raw take where I just watched Leonard Bernstein conduct at Ely Cathedral, so I had that to study, he would say. Carey Mulligan dropped out of her next project, Fingernails, due to supplementary filming for this film, and she was 12 weeks pregnant at the time of filming. Bradley Cooper would give direction to the camera operators while acting on camera by speaking to them when his back was turned or giving them gestures when his hands were out of frame. For example, in one scene when Lenny comforts Felicia after she's diagnosed with cancer, Bradley Cooper began speaking to the camera operator, telling him to move in closer. Cooper credited Mulligan for staying in character, not spoiling the take. Cooper's direction was removed in the sound mix. Leonard Bernstein was not only a talented musician, but also a polyglot. He was fluent in several languages, including English, French, Italian, German, and Hebrew. This linguistic skill allowed him to connect with musicians and audiences from different cultures and backgrounds. This is the first time Bradley Cooper and Carey Mulligan have worked together, not the first time the two had met. Mulligan suffered a head injury during her 2018 Broadway preview of playwright Dennis Kelly's Girls and Boys, after a heavy stage curtain struck her unexpectedly. Cooper happened to be in the theatre audience, and he accompanied her to urgent care in Manhattan. The David with whom Leonard Bernstein is romantically involved in the start of the film, played by Matt Bomer, was David Opperman, a classical clarinetist who later became a music and TV producer. Despite his attraction to men, he was married to women three different times, first to the actress Judy Holliday, with whom he had one son, the film editor Jonathan Oppenheim, a second child to Ellen Adler, with whom he had a daughter and a son, and the last to Patricia Jaffe. The film touches on Leonard Bernstein's relationship with musicologist and composer Thomas Cothran, who was 29 years younger. It doesn't mention that Bernstein left Felicia for Thomas in 1976. He went back the next year when she was diagnosed with breast cancer, which killed her in 1978. Thomas died in 1987 due to complications of AIDS. A few months later, Bernstein produced Music for Life, a celebratory benefit at Carnegie Hall for gay men's health crisis. The movie illustrates the historical fact that Felicia was aware of Leonard's sexual orientation and agreed to their marriage despite his lifelong attraction to men. In a letter Felicia wrote shortly after their marriage, Felicia frankly stated that she recognized and accepted Bernstein's homosexuality and alluded to the arrangement that he would be free to do as he liked without guilt and confession. This understanding between them did not keep Bernstein from undergoing years of so-called conversion therapy, the now debunked false idea that one can change their sexual orientations through psychiatric or medical therapies. Bernstein himself would announce his retirement from conducting on October 9, 1990. He died just 5 days later, at the age of 72, from a heart attack. Now, I found this to be a wonderfully poignant and beautifully made film. And the mere fact that Bradley Cooper not only stars in the lead role, but directs the film too, is just absolutely phenomenal. Bradley Cooper is an actor who has reinvented himself. It's hard for me to think back to films like the Hangover trilogy. He's become such a serious, well-rounded and dramatic actor, and now too a prolific director. But for me, this is arguably one of his best performances on screen. I feel he captures the magic and majesty and the great talent and genius that Leonard Bernstein possessed. Yet he also portrays him as a flawed, depressed man who behind the genius could not resist the temptation of the flesh. The chemistry now between Carey Mulligan and Bradley Cooper is off the charts. They're absolutely both wonderful in their respective roles. I love the choice of also shooting the film initially in black and white and then changing to colour as the couple aged. Carey Mulligan delivers one of her finest performances ever. She's absolutely magnificent here, as the classy, radiant, and sophisticated Felicia Montealegre. It's a heart-wrenching performance, particularly of course when she's diagnosed with cancer. But throughout the film, she absolutely adores and loves this man, but has to put up with the mere fact that their marriage doesn't just involve the two of them. The soundtrack is also absolutely spellbinding, and you realize just how phenomenally talented Leonard Bernstein was. One of my favorite scenes though in the film has to be when he conducts Mahler's Resurrection Symphony at the Ely Cathedral in England. It's absolutely beautiful performance here from Cooper, and the music is just so stirring, rousing, and emotionally charging that it just can't help but move you. This is an incredibly well-produced, well-made, beautifully acted film. And yes, the film tends to focus more on the relationship side of Bernstein's life than his actual musical genius. But in the same breath though, I feel it does justice to this man's complicated, enigmatic, yet brilliant existence. This film portrays Bernstein's passion for life, all the utter indulgences that he took part in, his great love for his wife and for his many suitors, and gives you a sort of sneak peek behind the genius. With its fantastic performances here from Cooper, but particularly Mulligan, wonderful direction here from Cooper, and fantastic and wonderful soundtrack, Maestro is a superb piece of filmmaking. Maestro gets a 9 out of 10.